people. The English language is always compelled to adapt. Even at times of crisis, new words are born. Well, have you encountered a coffin dodger? Do you enjoy a quarantine at Locktela? Do you understand these words? Quarantine, Locktela, coffin dodger. So friends, if you don't know what these terms mean, let's watch this video. I'm Susan. I will tell you what lockdown lingos are. So shall we start? The first term, COVID-19. It is a mild to severe respiratory illness that is caused by a coronavirus. One that is characterized especially by fever, cough, and shortness of breath and may progress to pneumonia and respiratory failure. It was first identified in Wuhan, China in December 2019. Next term, social distance. Social distance has been in use since the early 19th century, initially with the meaning of the degree of acceptance or rejection of social interaction between individuals and especially those belonging to different social groups, such as those based on race, ethnicity, class or gender. In modern use, the term is more often encountered with the meaning of the avoidance of close contact with other people during the outbreak of a contagious disease in order to minimize exposure and reduce the transmission of infection. So in short, social distancing is the practice of reducing close contact between people to slow the spread of infections or diseases. Social distancing measures include limiting large groups of people coming together, closing buildings and cancelling events. Examples of social distancing that allow you to avoid larger crowds or crowded spaces are working from home instead of at the office, virtually family and friends by using electronic devices instead of in person, closing schools or switching to online classes or learning, cancelling or postponing conferences, large meetings, etc. Next word is fomite. Means objects or materials which are likely to carry infection, such as clothes, utensils and furniture. The classic example of a fomite is a park water fountain from which many people drink. Infectious agents deposited by one person can potentially be transmitted to a subsequent drinker. Next, three very common and advanced words that are being used in this time. They are epidemic, pandemic, and outbreak. An outbreak is a sudden rise in the incidence of a disease. An epidemic is an outbreak of disease that spreads quickly and affects many individuals at the same time. Pandemic is an outbreak of a disease that occurs over a wide geographic area and affects an exceptionally high proportion of the population. Now I am going to construct some sentences related to these words. For example, there was an outbreak in Italy. There was an outbreak in Italy. When the outbreak spread, it became an epidemic. When the outbreak spread, it became an epidemic. Next, the WHO declared COVID-19 a pandemic. The World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a pandemic. The health authorities took various measures. They wanted to limit the transmission of the virus. People who have the coronavirus must be in isolation. People who might have coronavirus are asked to be in quarantine. The city is in lockdown. Next, community spread and contact tracing. Community spread is the spread of a contagious disease within a community. Contact tracing is the practice of identifying and monitoring individuals who may have had contact with an infectious person as a means of controlling the spread of a communicable disease. Next term, to self-quarantine. It means to refrain from any contact with other individuals for a period of time, such as 2 weeks or 4 weeks, during the outbreak of a contagious disease, usually by remaining in one's home and limiting contact with family members. Next term, quarantine. It is currently most often found with the meaning of a restraint upon the activities or communication of persons or the transport of goods designed to prevent the spread of disease or pest. Next term, index case. It is the first documented case of an infectious disease or genetically transmitted condition or mutation in a population, region or family. It may also, however, refer to an individual who has a disease or condition or mutation that is the first one identified in a population. The second sense is synonymous with index patient. A related term is patient zero. Patient zero. It means a person identified as the first to become infected with an illness or disease in an outbreak. Patient zero is especially used to refer to a person documented as being the first known case of a communicable disease in a particular population or region. Next term, super spreader. It means an individual who is highly contagious and capable of transmitting a communicable disease to an unusually large number of uninfected individuals. For example, the recent Kasaragod issue in Kerala. Contact with already infected persons and possible infection from foreign returners are seen as the causes of virus spread there. In India, the first case of COVID-19 was confirmed in Thrissur, Kerala on 30th January 2020. As of 1st May 2020, there have been 497 confirmed cases with 392 recoveries and 3 deaths in the state. Kerala has the lowest mortality rate of 0.6% among all states in India. Kerala's success in containing COVID-19 has been widely praised. For the first time after 45 days, Kerala reported no COVID-19 positive cases on 1st May 2020. Next terms, isolation and self-isolation. Isolation means the process of isolating or being isolated. For example, denoting a hospital or ward for patients with contagious or infectious diseases. Self-isolation means the act of isolating or separating oneself or itself from others. Contagious means a disease spread from one person or organism to another by direct or indirect contact. Infectious means a disease likely to be transmitted to people, organisms, etc. through the environment. An ailment such as food poisoning is infectious. It is capable of producing infection, but it is not contagious. The coronavirus, on the other hand, is both contagious and infectious. Anything that is contagious is automatically also infectious, but the reverse is not true. Next term, virus. It means an infective agent that typically consists of a nucleic acid molecule and a protein called too small to be seen by light microscopy and is able to multiply only within the living cells of a host. Next terms are trending words in 2020. The first term, quacksalver. It means one falsely claiming to possess medical or other skills, especially one who dispenses potions, ointments, etc., supposedly having curative powers. Next term, disinfectant. It means a chemical liquid that destroys bacteria. It causes the destruction of bacteria. Next interesting slang word is useful for your locktail R. The term is quarantine. It means experimental cocktails mixed from whatever random ingredients you have left in your home. The boozy or addicted equivalent of a stall cupboard supper. Next slang word, Corona Coaster. the ups and downs of your mood during the pandemic. You are loving lockdown 1 minute, but suddenly sniveling with anxiety the next. It's certainly an emotional corona coaster. Next slang word, coronials. It means future generation of babies conceived during coronavirus quarantine. They might also become known as Generation C. Next slang word, look reserve rest. It means it is the new avocado hand, an aching arm after taking one's best saucepan outside to bang during the weekly clap for carers. It might be heavy, but you are keen to impress the neighbors with your high-quality kitchenware. Next funny slang word, mascara. It means extra makeup applied to make one's eyes pop before venturing out in public wearing a face mask. Next slang word, furlough merlo. It means one consumed in an attempt to relieve the frustration of not working, also known as bored ox or carbonate tedium. Next term, COVID-10. It means the 10 kgs in weight that we are all gaining from comfort eating and comfort drinking, also known as fattening the curve. Next slang word, corona dose. It means an overdose of bad news from consuming too much media during a time of crisis. It can result in a panic-demic. Next slang word, coughing dodger. It means someone so alarmed by an innocuous or harmless splutter or throat clear that they back away in terror. Next funny slang word, the elephant in the zoo. The glaring issue during a video conferencing call that nobody feels able to mention. For example, one participant has dramatically put on weight, suddenly sprouted terrible facial hair, or has a worryingly messy house visible in the background. Next common slang word, antisocial distancing. It means using health precautions as an excuse for snubbing neighbors and generally ignoring people you find irritating. Next significant slang term, COVIDiot or Wuhanker. COVIDiot or Wuhanker. It means one who ignores public health advice or behaves with reckless disregard for the safety of others can be said to display COVIDiosity or be COVIDiotic, also called a log clown or even a Wuhanker. Next top level slang word, gout break. Means the sudden fear that you have consumed so much wine, cheese, homemade cake and Easter chocolate in lockdown that your ankles are swelling up like a medieval king's. Next funny thing, Kruger cut. It means self-administered haircut performed during lockdown with results so disastrous that you might as well have let Freddy Krueger from A Nightmare on Elm Street hack away at your bonds with his blade-tipped fingers. Next phrase, shirking from home. It means the person who never did any work in the office and now not doing any work in their kitchen. Next slang word, asymptomatic. It means state of having been locked down for so long that you repeatedly cry out, oh for God's sake, when is this nightmare ever going to end? Next funny slang word, Pinot Grigio. It means the temptation you feel whenever you open the fridge to get the milk for a cup of tea, but then notice that chilled bottle of wine lurking so provocatively at the back. Humpty Dumpty, Humpty Dumpty. Oh no, it's not Humpty Dumpty. The phrase is Trumpty Dumpty. It means the great fall in global morale experienced whenever the President of the United States reveals his latest thinking on the causes of or possible solutions to the coronavirus pandemic. The last slang word, vapidemic. It means the outbreak of meaningless and badly thought through opinionating that always occurs in response to any new coronavirus development or statistic or forecast or presidential press conference. So friends, I hope you understand all the terms, slang words and phrases about COVID-19. So guys, I will be back with another video soon. So stay safe, stay home. Stay calm and positive and stay healthy and stay safe. Okay friends, bye.